Good evening. My name is Kyara Taylor, and I'm from Betty Shabazz. Today, here, I have my friend Ranayah. She's also from Betty Shabazz. Ranayah, do you want to introduce yourself?
My name is Ranayah Rocquemore.
What grade are you in?
Sixth grade.
Here we go. We go to Barbara A. Sizemore Academy at 6547 Street, Stewart Avenue, Chicago, Illinois 60621. Or go to our thing at www.bsics.org or call 773-651-1616. So, Ranayah, today we're going to be talking about bullying. Have you ever been bullied?
No, but I know other people that have been bullied.
Okay, so have you ever thought of, like, committing any type of suicide because you have may or may have not been bullied?
No, but I have other friends that was trying to commit suicide.
Okay, so did you do anything about her thoughts? Did you help her?
Yes, I did.
Okay, so do you know anything about people being cyberbullied?
Well, yeah, my best friend, she was bullied by another student in the classroom on Snapchat.
Oh, it's always those social media, right? Well, so I've been thinking, have you, like, ever tried to tell a bully to not bully another student? Like, did you help them with their consequences?
Yes, I did.
What did you do?
I went up to the person and I was, like, talking to them and trying to convince them to stop bullying because you don't want anyone to bully you.
Did they stop?
Yes, they did.
Okay, did you feel good about helping another student?
Yes, I felt great.
I know that's right. I would also feel great. But anyways, so, like, does your friend still think about committing suicide or even hurting herself?
No, she doesn't.
So she must have really listened to your words then.
Yeah.
Okay. So do you have any, like, friends who bully people? Like, any of your friends? Your friends with a bully?
No, not at all.
I honestly think you chose the right role. So, anyways, so, how do you like the school? Is the school good?
Yes, I love my school. My school is great.
So, I see you got a lot of friends at the school, and I know I'm one of them. But is there anybody you would like to say hi to?
Yes. My mom, dad. Oh, you, especially you, and a lot of people saw that.
Okay. So have you witnessed any bullying? Well, I've witnessed bullying before. So, it was actually me getting bullied before by a lot of people. A lot of people call me ugly. They say I have no edges. And I just tell them, hey, find something new to say. I hear it a lot. And they just still keep going. I mean, I know how to ignore people. People push my limits, and I still just ignore them. And they don't stop. But they'll learn to stop one day. Because if they bully me, one day they'll get bullied and see how I felt when they bullied me. I'm not really going to say any names because, I mean... So, I've actually thought of hurting myself because of bullying. But then I got my right mindset of just telling people that, you know what, I don't care. I'm not going to hurt myself because of something you said. And you think I'm going to hurt myself, because you want to bully me? I'm not feeling it. Oh, looks like we have a caller. Caller, are you there?
Okay. Yes. Do you think it's ever okay for girls to get in a fight if they're being bullied?
No, I don't think that's okay because, I mean, you get in trouble. Everybody's action is followed by a consequence. It's never right to fight anybody. Oh, looks like we have another caller. Caller, are you still there?
Hello, little girls. How you doing this evening?
Good. How are you?
I'm okay. And let's get back to this bullying situation here, which isn't very nice. It's not nice for anybody to call anybody kind of name. You are both beautiful children. We are all children of God. There's beauty in all of us. We got to turn the hate around and make some more love. But in getting back to the bullying part, when you have somebody bullying you, you call your parents, and your parents are called those parents. You kids are so smart on these telephones these days. You could call your mama or daddy in a matter of a second and have them, their parents call the little girl that's bullying you and let your mama and daddy take care of it. There is no reason. Bullying been going on since the dinosaur days. And in the old days, we used to say, when the people would tell you that you this and you that, they used to say that an insult is the most important part of flattery. They just jealous. You got something they ain't got. They ain't got something. We got to love each other. You are the next generation, little girls. You're the next generation. Technology taking you way up to the moon. But you got to involve your mama and your daddy. Their mama and your daddy and your school teacher. You go straight to the school teacher. Our taxpayer paying those teachers. You go up to the lady, you take her on the side, real quiet, and say, looky here. I got a problem with the little girl over in the third seat, blah, blah, blah. She don't like the babushka or the way my hair look today. Can you take care of him? My mama telephone number. I know some of us ain't got no mamas or daddies, but I know we got a bigger sister, or we got a bigger brother. We got somebody. We're going to get to the end of the bullying, but we're going to start with you two little girls on the TV tonight. You both look beautiful. Say hey. Wave the Auntie Paula. Let me.
God bless you. So, cyberbullying is a big thing in life. A lot of people cyberbully because they have no meaning of just trying to be somebody's friend in person. I mean, they think, oh, I'm going to just cyberbully this kid because he has a fresher haircut than me, and I'm not going to tell him that in person. I'm just bullying him on social media. So, like, if you want to cyberbully somebody, you might want to think twice about that because a lot of people have family that can just easily just confront you. And I don't think you would want to get confronted by anybody, not even a family member. And what if you were cyberbullied? How would you feel? How would you look? You would look like a total idiot, wouldn't you? Exactly. So you might want to think twice about bullying in person or even cyberbullying, because that can turn into something way worse. So, Ranayah, if you ever think about cyberbullying, that would not be a good look for you. Or even personally bullied. Do you know anybody who's ever been cyberbullied? I actually have one thing to say. One time, my friend, we were just on her phone, just looking at stuff, when she got on, like, this video. Or a text message, I forgot what it was, but it was a text message, I think, from a sixth grade hater. And we're in sixth grade, and we are known as Sankofa in Bahasa.
Yeah.
So it was a Sankofa hater, and they sent a really mean message to our friend, which hurt our hearts, because we've never done anything wrong. We've always listened, and that person was probably a real hater if they want to call themselves Sankofa hater. They were probably a real hater. Sure. Because, I mean, a lot of people in that school, like, love Sankofa. I mean, we're sweet and adorable. But if you want to hate on us, I mean, you might want to look at yourself, man. So, anyway, you can come to our school at Barbara A. Sizemore Academy at 6547 Street, Stewart Avenue, Chicago, Illinois, 60621. or go to www.bsics.org or call 773-651-1616. Here's a little of my answers. Oh, look at me. All beautiful and everything. She's also a dancer herself. We actually, looks like we have a caller. Caller?
Right here.
Oh, the caller's not there, I guess. So, near her, we actually have our own dance made up.
Yeah, and we have a talent show.
We have a talent show coming up, too, at our school. And we hope some of you guys can join us at our school. It would be very, very nice if you can join. I mean, it would be a nice thing to do. I mean, you don't have to if you don't want to, but I mean, it would be good. Looks like we've got a caller. Caller!
Hi, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Hi, ladies. This is Bryson and Caitlin's mom. How are you?
Good.
I just want to call. I want to call in and say that you all look beautiful.
Thank you
so much.
And want to thank you for covering this topic because it's extremely important in your community, your group, your friends. And I want the world to know that I've witnessed both of you all stand up to bullies. And I want to publicly thank you for being there for your friends, staying strong, staying positive, and not being afraid to protect your classmates. So I just wanted to thank you all, okay?
You're welcome. That's a nice thing to do, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Very nice.
A great thing.
Great thing. So, how is the food at the school? I heard their pizza is banging.
Yes, great.
I loved it.
And it's homemade.
Homemade?
Well, schoolmade, because school, you know.
I mean, it's basically our home. There's no other school I would want to call home than Boston.
That's true.
That's the school of everything. We got dance, digital media art, we got music, gym, and we also get technology class. So, here is another video called Black Lives Always Strive.
Hi, y'all. About to get lit for Kwanzaa, y'all. Here we go. Turn up. Faith is the thing that keeps you alive. And the strive with this black lives. We in the basement getting lost in our faces. But we all know that Donald Trump is racist. He's trying to end our lives, but we still strive. So we look ahead of time, so we won't get bigger crimes.
And the things that rhyme, and the time you know we gon' fail. I can tell. Faith is the thing that keeps you alive against black lives. And keep the time, it rhymes.
Never die, always try. Faith can keep you alive. With our black lives, all we do is strive. Strive, strive, and strive, strive.
Black lives always strive. All lives always strive. Black lives always strive. Black lives always strive.
aren't they adorable? That was... Whoa! Where'd you kick here? Well, I would really like to thank Ranayah for being here. And Marteo, so why is it important for youth to be healthy?
I mean, you can always, it's like more healthier because you it's like a life expands more, and when you're heavy set, like life is shortened for you, and it's hard to maintain that process, so you have to like keep trying to maintain.
Looks like we have a caller. Caller, you there?
Yes, I am. I just wanted to say you are absolutely a breath of fresh air. This is the first time I've seen your show. I love your talent. I love your ability to be a good hostess. And I want to encourage you, as well as Martell and the other young lady, you keep doing what you're doing. We need you as Black people. We need you to showcase who you are and shine, honey. You are beautiful, and I can see the sunshine in your eyes. So thank you so much, and I am so proud to have witnessed such a great talent, especially among Black African people. I say, shout out to Betty Shabazz.
Every caller on the show is always so sweet. Oh, looks like we have another caller. Caller?
Hello?
Hello?
Yes, I have a question for Ranayah.
She's listening.
Is Ranayah still available?
She...
Just go stand up behind her.
Here she is.
Here's
Ranayah. Hello.
Hello, Ranayah?
Yeah.
I have a question for you. How do you feel about the topic on health?
On health?
Yes, on health.
I feel good about it.
Feel good about health?
Yeah.
What is your views on the food that you eat? What is your views on how people eat in the world today?
I think that people eat good at our school. Because it's a vegetarian school, so it's good.
Looks like we got another caller. Thanks, Renai.
I feel good about it.
So what is your view of how people eat in the world?
Just go.
Okay. Anyways, Martell, what kind of food do you eat to stay healthy?
I mean, I eat like every other kid. Be eating them hot fries, some hot Cheetos, things like that.
Let me stop you right there. That is very unhealthy, Martell.
Yeah, but I'm on the basketball team, so it's easy to work those out, like, and it would just go away.
But those type of foods can mess with your mind.
Yeah, but
and probably your weight too. But anyways.
Well, actually, kids gonna be kids. You can like still eat. It doesn't matter how you eat, but it's like how much you eat of it. And those certain bags of chips and like some juice pouches and stuff like that. Candy can like it could really irritate you.
Oh, seems like we have a caller. Caller.
Hello?
Hello.
Hi, this is Marie Taylor.
And I was calling to tell Kyra and her co-host that you all are doing a very good job. And I'm very proud of you.
Thank you, Auntie Yuri.
All right. Love you.
Love you, too.
Bye.
So, Martell, let me stop you right there. Oh, it's another caller. Caller.
Hello?
Hello.
Hey, I would have a question about vegan products.
Okay. We're listening.
Hello?
We're listening. Okay, so Martell, let me tell you one thing. One, those chips and stuff can mess with your teeth. Two, it can mess with your weight. Three, just because you're on the basketball team does not mean all that weight is going to go off. I mean, it goes through your, it like travels through your brain and it can mess you up, man.
It's easy to say that I drink a lot of water every day, so I can like wash that stuff off. And like kids doesn't, like, they don't understand at this moment in their life how to maintain to eat. Like, some people just to eat, and they don't understand, like, that it could be more healthier just to eat, like, some, like, baked chips and things like that, but kids just gonna be kids.
So, do you, like, oh, looks like we have another caller. Caller! Hello?
Hey, how you doing?
Good.
Can I get Ranayah back on the line?
Here she
goes. I have something for all of y'all.
Okay. So, anyways, so Martell, is there anything you'd like to say, like goodbye to anyone or hi?
Shout out to 8th grade class. You know, we got that 8th grade trip coming up. It's finna be lit. And shout out to Jason, Eddie. He don't eat at home sometimes. Shout out to Julian, Jeremiah, Devonshay, Jaheim, and the rest of them.
I would like to give a shout out to the whole entire Sankofa class, my teacher, Mama Leticia, the digital media arts teacher. I would actually like to give a shout out to every single person in Barbara A. Sizemore. I would like to give a shout out to the whole school. So, anyways, like I said, go to Barbara A. Sizemore Academy at 6547 Street, Stewart Avenue, Chicago, Illinois, 60621, or go to www.bsics.org, or call 773-651-1616. Thank you. Oh, yeah, one more thing. Martell, you need to stop eating all the junk. And for any other kid, no more junk. It can mess you up. Thank you. Goodbye.